rice, food, I eat. And this is, by the way, nutritious food and not super expensive. I have a tea in my can. I have to put out the tea in the video is 10 minutes at a half. I have to make a split and then I take out the tea and then I have new tea for my cup because I having sometimes problem with drinking 2 to 3 liters per day, and so a little kind of tracker helps me to keep my intake of water or whatever is balanced. And no, I don't drink something like juices on a regular basis. I barely drink them. It's really not often that I drink juice. I don't drink soft drinks on a regular basis. It's at least one time a month, but there were times when I had no Coke or whatever in years. It's the same with alcohol. So no, I don't drink this industrial produced poison for humans. It's the same with alcohol. What alcohol is doing to your liver, do the math, do the research, and then you will never drink alcohol again. To everyone else who's always blaming me for I'm not that person anymore that I was in the past. So you of course know which person I was in past because I stood in front of the camera and did sexy photographs. So you of course know who I am. You of course know who I am when you stalking my Facebook. And you of course knowing who I am just in meeting me, I do not know, in an interval from 6, 7, up to 10 years for a limited time where you accept yourself the timer. So you of course know who I am and you of course know my private life. So yeah. What else? It's none of your business with whom I in a partnership or relationship. It's none of your business what is going on with my medical or physical health. But I'm kind and I'm polite, so I posted some diagnostic papers on my Instagram for you, so you can look it up and make yourself a picture what is going on with my person. And what happened with my body and with my breasts and with my mental state of mind in past, so you can make yourself a picture. You can also create yourself a picture that I'm a psychopath because of these papers and that I'm hurting other people and then I'm a freak and that I'm a nightmare in relationships. Feel free, everything is online. Do yourself a picture of who I am. It's pretty helpful and should I stop the video? I think I just standing up, leaving the display alone. And behind me there's a mess because I'm sewing at the moment again. And then I'm back with my tea. Mighty. My playing cards. I ordered them today completely like it should be, like it's in the manual, so all these are not shuffled, but they are ordered in a complete fresh new order, ready to get read or not to get read or whatever. And I have them here on my table. I created the table kind of myself. If someone is asking, no, it doesn't was a commissioned work. It doesn't was a freelancer work. It just was my kind of being creative. Because, oh wonder, I was once got permission to study art history in Germany, in my hometown Leipzig. And when you applying for art study, sorry, my arm is currently here. When you applying for art study, you have to. Every child should know that. Have to do different kind of paintings, collagen, whatever, what you're doing artistically, and you have to send it to the university and everything, and then you wait if you are organized and tough enough with a hidden political statement, or if you are freaky enough to study art history, it's called Kunstgeschichte, in Germany. I got the okay, and I was happy as I got the okay. And I'm, like I told in other videos, I'm normally a left hand. I'm pretty skilled with my left hand when it comes to painting and whatever. But it turned out at school, teachers decided if she can also do something with her right hand. So they put me, my persona, as little child beside my best girlfriend. My best girlfriend sat on my left side, and I also only could had the right side open to grab the pen or whatever. And it turned out, yes, I also can do something with my right hand. So naturally, you know, when you're having a kid and you're putting a pen in front of the kid and a blank paper, what is the kid doing? Do the kid using their right hand first or their left hand first? And I always used my left hand first for whatever, as far as I can remember. And my parents, they also told that in school. And it turned out I can also write with my right hand. But I'm super. It's a kind of I'm a little one when writing and write with my right hand because I'm super lazy. I don't have speed. So at university, where everyone did super fast notes, I freaked out every time, and I kind of taught myself a kind of coding shortening system. How to put down important notes in a short amount of time, like the teacher in front of you or the professor is telling you. And I figured out a little system for myself to keep track and to keep with the other people's because I'm not that fast with my right hand. So, and it turned out it worked. It really worked pretty well. So, video number two, and like I said before in the other video, I look myself up, stamp myself as crazy, and above that, from your view of the size of my dinner, you can also stamp me as I do have eating issues. Whatever. Stamp me at whatever you want. I'm used to it. To get stamped and to get judged all the time since childhood. I'm eating. Ta-da! Ring! I'm eating too fast. I'm eating too slow. I'm a picky eater. Why you don't eat this? Everyone in our family does eat this. Why you don't eat this? Are you in exceptions? Do you like to be an exception? No, I just don't like to eat it. And the proof is made pretty easy. Give me something I absolutely hate. There is not much on food I hate, despite the fact I'm mostly vegan. And try to avoid milk products, cow milk products, or goat milk products. There's really not much I don't eat. But when I say no, and I don't like this food, it's mostly forever that I don't like this food. This food is, for example, pineapple. Black olives. Red onions. What is it called? Carbon? I do not know. Also green olives. I do not like. And other things. But the main thing is really olives and pineapple. Why? I can't tell you. Brussels sprout, is that the right word for it? I have to google it up. Rosenkohl. Rosenkohl. Ich mache mal so ein Ding da rein, wie das heißt. Ich habe das in meinem Mund und ich bekomme Würgereflex. Das ist jetzt nicht, dass ich psychologisch eine Meise habe oder so. Ich habe das im Mund, ich bekomme Würgereflex. Das habe ich bei Ananas. Wie gesagt, das habe ich auch bei Oliven. Und es hat sich sogar rausgestellt, weil ich habe das seit ich Kind bin. Da funktioniert auch der Würgereflex. Das heißt, wenn ich das aufessen soll, und schön brav als Kind macht man das natürlich, man isst es auf, hast das Postwenden wieder auf dem Teller. Aber unabhängig davon ist es für mich sehr faszinierend, wie die Geschmacksnerven der Menschen so sind. Ist es so, dass wenn ich das esse, ich kann dir die kleinste Spur rausschmecken. Da kann der Salat, der Saft noch so gestreckt sein. Der kann noch so mit anderen Superboostern an Vitaminen zusammengehauen sein. Sobald Ananas drin ist, sobald Oliven, grüne oder schwarze dabei sind, ich schmeck dir das sofort raus. Ich stell dir das hin, steh auf und gehe. Und wenn du das weißt, dass ich das nicht mag und es trotzdem machst, bin ich als letztes Mal vom Tisch aufgestanden und gegangen. Ganz einfach. Ja, so viel dazu, was ich von Ananas halte. Ananas ist, mag gesund sein. Googelt man alle Benefits von Ananas, mag Ananas sehr, sehr gesund sein, auf jeden Fall. Es ist ein sehr modern gewordenes Obst. Exotik in den letzten Jahren. Sehr, sehr viel Aufmerksamkeit bekommen die Ananas. Die Ananas ist hochgradig verzuckert von oben bis unten. Sonst würde man das nicht rausschmecken, sobald man Mindestbestandteile davon drin hat, was bei jemandem, wenn er eine Allergie hat, einen allergischen Schock auslösen kann. Die Ananas. Gibt dir jemand ein Goodie? Du kaufst irgendetwas. Beispiel Gummibärchen oder so, gibt es die verschiedensten Geschmackrichtungen und so, gibt dir halt so ein Goodie und es stellt sich raus, oh, es ist Ananas. Und kann sein, dass du danach einen allergischen Schock hast und danach auf die Straße kotzt. Gibt's alles. Sollte man vielleicht mitbedenken, wenn es um Essen oder ähnliches geht. Eine Ananas ist ja auch schon gelb, ne? Mit den Spitzen sieht alles so nett aus und ja, mag sein. Ich selber kann, was es gesundheitlich angeht, von Ananas nichts Positives, nichts Negatives berichten. Ich bin da neutral, die Schweiz, beziehungsweise ich kann ja nicht mal neutral sein, ich habe da null Meinung dazu, weil ich finde es eklig. Ich finde die Obstsorte eklig von oben bis unten. Ich weiß nicht, was es ist. Es löst Ekel, Abstoßung in mir aus. Mir zieht sich alles zusammen. Ich finde es einfach boah. kriegst du mich nicht. Kannst du noch so viel Positives erzählen, wie positiv Ananas oder Oliven sind oder rote Zwiebeln oder was auch immer. Ich glaub dir das, dass es so ist, aber jeder Körper ist halt verschieden. Und jeder Körper benötigt verschiedene Sachen. Und was für den einen Medizin ist oder gut ist, ist für den anderen Körper halt Gift. Deswegen, nee, mit Ananas oder mit Oliven. Das gibt's nämlich nicht. Ist so. Und jeder, der auf dieses gehypte Boot aufgesprungen ist in den letzten 7, 8 Jahren oder so, hat für mich, wenn ich moody drauf bin, wenn ich nicht gut drauf bin, einen Dachschaden, der bis zum Himmel schallt. Warum das so ist? Weil es nicht normal ist, psychisch nicht normal, den ganzen Tag mit einem Kaulquappen-Froschgesicht in die Kamera zu grinsen. Psychologisch ist nicht normal, ist krank. Ist einfach nur krank. Ebenso ist es auch nicht normal, sich als Sportmodel oder so zu verkaufen oder jemanden als Sportmodel zu verkaufen, der augenscheinlich keine Muskeln hat. Ist krank. Das ist unsere deutsche Gesellschaft, die ist heutzutage krank von oben bis unten. Aber alle machen mit. Weil die Bots mögen das ja, die Agenturen mögen das ja. Alle finden das ja toll, deswegen machen wir mit. Das ist wie so ein Viehtrend, ne? Machen wir halt alle mit. Ja. Ein Grund, warum noch andere Gründe, warum ich mich hier beim Essen filme. Ich habe früher, wie gesagt, ich kann euch da mal Fotos posten, sehr, sehr viel Sport gemacht. Ich habe verschiedene Sachen schon durchprobiert. Ich war im Gym, ich habe Home Workouts gemacht, ich habe Balletttraining beispielsweise auch gemacht. Ja, habe ich auch gemacht. Ich kann nicht Ballett tanzen, aber ich habe schon mal Balletttraining gemacht. Ich habe schon mal Jazz-Tanz gehabt und alles Mögliche. Und das war vor 6, 7 Jahren. Ganz toll auf Social Media, überall. Schreibt irgendwelche Firmen an mit Proteinriegel, mit allem drum und dran. Ich habe Proteinriegel, ich habe die Firmen nicht angeschrieben. Doch, teilweise habe ich sie angeschrieben. Ich habe die Sachen selber gekauft und habe die in meine IG reingetan, in meine Stories. Damals hatte ich noch meine IG. Der wurde mir im Dezember 2018 aus heiterem Himmel gelöscht. Ich gehe stark davon aus, dass das alles mitgeschnitten worden ist, dass das alles recorded worden ist im guten, tollen Silicon Valley. Oder irgendjemand hat mir von meinen Mädels richtig gut gegen das Bein gepisst, weil sie mich nicht ausstehen können. Und deswegen, ja, ich kenne diese ganzen Labels, diese ganzen Firmen, worauf alle großen Stars und Sternchen habe ich mir gekauft. Teilweise hat es geschmeckt, teilweise hat es nicht geschmeckt. Das Problem ist, die normalen Mädels auf der Straße, die normalen Frauen auf der Straße sind teilweise gebildeter. Die haben teilweise mehr Muskeln, die können teilweise besser die Sportübungen ausführen, die können die teilweise besser erklären. Aber die bekommen keine Reichweite und die bekommen keine Stimme, weil sie halt keine fancy Krankheit haben, die sie vorführen können. Und genau deswegen mache ich das, ne? Genau deswegen tue ich meine ganzen Arztbelege drüben auf IG hochladen. Damit jeder denkt, ich will jetzt ins fette Business-Geschäft einsteigen, ins fette IG-Promotion-Geschäft einsteigen und will mit allen anderen überhaupt nichts mehr zu tun haben. Genau deswegen mache ich das. Die Antworten, die sind so einfach. Die sind so einfach. Man muss nur wissen, wie es geht. Die sind so einfach. So, and I will now. Or I'm gonna speak in English now. And what I told in my previous videos, where I made the split in the half in German language, it's not important. It's really not important. Because it's almost like I would have a shaved head, but I don't have a shaved head. I just did my platinum blonde again. Yeah, because I uploading all these medical things on my IG. It's the most thing I'm doing this is I would like to get famous, and I would like to convince the majority of people that I living a healthy lifestyle. That's really, that's exactly why I'm doing this. To convince everyone who is watching this that I don't drink all its tea, that I don't need a regularly a beer at dinner or wine at dinner or whatever. Because when you drink in wine on a regular basis, we talking about a casual glass or so, 3 times a week, 4 times a week on a regular basis over half year, then you are addicted. Long time periodically, you're an alcoholic. So no, I don't do this. Wine, I only like white wine. White wine, I don't like red wine for some strange reason. I don't like red wine. I'm not a champagne person and I'm not a sparkling wine person. But I'm a cocktail person. I must honestly admit that is one of my weakness. I'm a cocktail person, but I barely drink cocktails. Really, I don't drink them so much. It's sometimes there were years I hadn't touched any cocktail, also any virgin, no virgin cocktail, nothing. Also no alcoholic drink or cocktail, but I like cocktails. Cocktails are good, and when you are familiar with cocktails, the judgment, these are hard drugs, this is hard alcohol, is bullshit. Sorry when I'm saying that out loud, that's bullshit. Yes, there is high percentage alcohol in there, but you barely drink them pure. When you sometimes drinking things like vodka pur, there you must be really devastated. And then I would be really sorry and would say please go in therapy. But normal cocktails, that's why they are not as cheap as a beer or a wine or something. Normally cocktails are starting from 6-7 euro up to the roof. There is good alcohol in there, mixed with fruit things and whatever. So for me, it's just more tastier than beer. There are really interesting sorts of beer on the market, also on wine. But I'm not that person. So it's like when you have a kind of cake or something, you have, which is tasting pretty particular. So and that's for me the same with wine and with beer and everything. That's the tasting of alcohol, also from cocktails. I don't like to have on a daily basis. For some strange reason, my body is saying no that I. So my body is saying no. I just don't like it. I don't drink it. I don't want it. But then there are times when I have the craving that I think, oh, a cocktail would be nice. Oh, okay, now a beer would be nice. But the intervals, they are really changing. So like I said, there were years when I haven't touched any alcohol, when I haven't touched any cocktails. Then there were times when I really drank more cocktails. For example, 1 or 2 months where I had a cocktail once a week or so, or where I drank a beer, not every week, but I do not know, 1 beer a week over a half year or something, but that's the maximum. So that's my alcohol consume. So that's my living. And often people are judging me. They are judging me because, oh, you don't drink alcohol so much, you are not natural, you are not cool enough, you are, I do not know, you are crazy. Then, ah, oh, you don't smoke. Then you are a freak when you don't smoke. I get hate speech because I don't smoke or I don't drink alcohol on a regular level. I got hate speech and mobbing because I'm living healthy. What came to the society in Germany? And then, I also got accused where I made myself the kind of experiment to stop drinking green tea and coffee because these caffeine things can do really bad things with your energy level in the body and something, and back then, my former partner, they really, he smoked a lot. He was super smoker and everything and other things. So it was, it's not that he's a bad person, but it was really, it sucked. It really, it sucked, and I hated this behavior, and that's one reason why it didn't work out for a long time. So, and he looked at me, and he really, you don't like coffee? You don't like to drink coffee now? You are so crazy. What, you now will try vegan? And he got angry. He got really angry at me, and I received looks from him as I just showed him a vegan book I like a lot. I still like a lot, and bought fresh. And that's really a look I will never forget. And this look was so judgmental. And really, sometimes looks are so judgmental. They are like a really crazy picture, or like a really like a scary picture. It's burned in your. It's like a picture is burning into the camera. It burned in my brain, in my memory. So I will not forget the picture. So that's something people should really be aware of when they judging and mobbing people out of the blue because they're feeling so, they have so much emotions because they are such an emo. Because that can really hurt people on a personal level, and yes, it can destroy relationship, or it can be the trigger or the starting point from a firework chain, that a relationship is exploding. So yeah, I'm eating healthy. I'm having a healthy lifestyle. No, I don't take drugs. I know people from my past, from my teenager time. They did drugs. They drank a lot of alcohol. Also, as teenager, I drank lots of alcohol, and I do know how shitty you feel afterwards when you drink too much alcohol. And I'm kind of proud of myself when I can say that. So that I'm over the phase that I need alcohol in my life, like the same I don't need coffee in my life. So I know people who are did drugs and doing drugs. I do know people in my life who are pretty much into cigarettes and alcohol, and I don't judge them. These are still in some way my family, my friends, and whatever, but I building up a big, big wall. I'm building up a big, big wall, and I'm building up a big, big line when they try to soak out the energy, my energy, into their unhealthy lifestyle because they feel shitty. You know, they had a bad day, they had a bad night, they hadn't slept well, they haven't kept their schedule and everything, and now they have to blame someone else, and this is normally the person who is healthy and who is working all the time, for example, in the household or whatever. Now the person who is keeping the things together. That is then the person, the healthy person who get all the shitstorm. So, and I will now finish this third video and wishing you a nice evening, and bye bye.